There are many countries in this world which are dealing with problems of poverty. They are denied basic amenities and access to livelihood, education, water supply, electricity and so on. To uplift these countries and for their sustainable development, international cooperation is required. For a better future, we have to start our efforts today. JICA, Japan International Cooperation Agency, is a governmental organization which implements Japan's official development assistance. JICA has its long history of more than half century, and since its establishment, JICA has been contributing to the development of developing countries. JICA works as a bridge between Japan and developing countries. It provides wide-range assistance in forms of loan, grant, and technical cooperation in integrated manners, so that the developing countries can strengthen their capacities. Today, JICA is one of the world's largest bilateral cooperation organization, and in India, JICA is its oldest and largest development partner. JICA's volunteer program is being implemented as part of Japan's Official Development Assistance, ODA. The program dispatches Japanese volunteers to utilize their skills, knowledge, and experience for the development. The objectives of this program are 1. To cooperate in the economic and social development as well as the reconstruction of developing countries. 2. To promote international goodwill and deepen mutual understanding. Since its first dispatch to Laos in 1965, more than 48,000 JICA volunteers have worked alongside local communities in 96 countries and regions, as summarized by the phrase, together with the local communities. JICA volunteers live and work at the grassroots level, speaking the same language as the local communities, and carrying out activities with an emphasis on fostering self-reliance for sustainable change. Volunteers are generally dispatched for 2 years in various fields ranging from teaching, sports, community development, nursing, and so on. The program is one of the most prominent ODA programs of Japan. The Imperial Family of Japan is also proud of the volunteers. India was one of the first recipient countries of the JOCV program when it started in 1966. In 2014, both India and Japan agreed to start dispatching senior volunteers, and JICA is now expecting expansion of activities and further collaboration between India and Japan through the volunteer programs as well as other projects. Until 2016, 200 volunteers have been dispatched all over India.
I'm Yohei Ida. As a community development officer, my work has started with baseline survey in the field. Kya apse do minute baad kar sakta hun? Mera naam Yohei Ida hai. Main resham ke bare mein RSRS mein kam karta hun. To abhi main is gaon mein survey kar raha hun. After I gather all necessary information, I will formulate self-help group among sericulture farmers. The self-help groups enables sericulture farmers to exchange their knowledge and share their best practices about sericulture. Also, I will facilitate the group activity. I found out from the survey that a lot of sericulture farmers don't wash their hands very often in their daily life. So if you wash your hand before touching silkworms, it can reduce risks for silkworms from getting disease from human. So I'm thinking about spreading the habit of hand wash in the village. At first, in the village, a lot of sericulture farmers were staring at me because I am a foreigner. But once they know that I can speak Hindi and this Japanese man is trying to do something in the village, they opened their heart and they start talking about themselves and they also talk about the problems they have.
My name is Aimuto. I teach Japanese language and Japanese culture to students who are interested in Japanese culture and languages, and also for the students who are seeking jobs opportunity in Japanese companies. As I am the only Japanese native language teacher, my role is very important. I can share my teaching method, which I have experienced and I have learned from the past experiences. Also for students, I give them opportunity to use Japanese practically. Japan and India share a cordial relationship. And in this situation, it is very important to understand mutually. As I teach language and introduce Japanese culture for the students, it is becoming a bridge of these two countries.
Ms. Aimuto, who has been deployed as a volunteer at Duni University, has been very helpful and encouraging in handling the department affairs like speech contest in the spoken Japanese, encouraging students to work more hard and speaking with them out of the class as well, which is very important for students at Dehradun who does not have much exposure to go out and talk with Japanese natives.
We have two volunteers in Dehradun and Haridwar. In Dehradun, Mr. Yohei Ida is there in Tiparpur cluster. His main emphasis since beginning is to create SSGs among sericulture farmers. And in Haridwar, we have another JOCV. His name is So Ozaki. And his main work since beginning is microfinancing. In his area, he has done preliminary work on microfinancing. And since that area is low in income group, his attention towards microfinancing was very catchy there. And he is doing very well at Haridwar. SSGs will help them, help the farmers with their economics. Microeconomics can be controlled by our poor villagers with the help of JOCVs by SSGs. They know what is good for sericulture, what is bad for sericulture. And when they intermingle with the farmers and they discuss several things with the farmers, then they tell the farmers what is right for sericulture.
Well, Ms. Kitehara is a supporting our master trainers to build their capacity further in the GMMT skills, and she is also helping our practitioners who are undergoing training at our institute in GMMT, which is a Japanese medical manual therapy. Well, our visually impaired students are now feeling very confident about starting their own ventures, their own small therapy clinics. Otherwise, you know, generally blind people are hesitant about starting self-employment ventures. But Ms. Kitehara has inspired them to open their own therapy clinics. One of them has already started and is very successful, and there's a second one who's completed all the preparations, and I think very soon he will also start his own clinic.
India is special for JICA, and JICA is active here from infrastructure development support to people-to-people collaboration. Both the prime ministers have agreed to expand JICA volunteer activities in many fields. JICA volunteers stay together, work together, think together, using the same local languages with Indian people. The exchange of thoughts and attitudes at the grassroots level, such as politeness, morality, and discipline, helps a lot for closer relations between the two nations. Many Japanese are eager for deeper mutual understanding and for inclusive development of India. JICA continues working with the people of India for a brighter future.
JICA volunteer program contributes to the development of people's life in local community. In addition, the interaction between volunteers and local people enhances our friendship and mutual understanding at grassroots level. The hard work and dedication by JICA volunteers have been highly appreciated by local people, and I'm proud of them. We hope to deepen our bilateral relationship through the cooperation and contribution to India under this program.